You know, I've talked to all of them. And I was pleasantly surprised that in spite of their, you know, what Kofi Annan called finger pointing, they actually have all of them, a reasonably responsible attitude. And all they need is really get together and try to find, you know, stop, you know, pointing their fingers at the other guy and really work out whatever disagreements they have and work out a process.
Okay, but let's take the Russians, because I've interviewed them all, including the Russian foreign minister here at this table, and, you know, and there are all kinds of issues that divide them. And one of the things that's interesting, I don't think the Russians, you correct me, are committed to Assad.
No, not at all.
You know,
not at all.
They're not offering him asylum, they're committed to him. They're basically saying, we think there has to be some kind of negotiation to solve this thing, rather than...
What they are saying is that it has to be a Syrian process, a Syrian-led process, which everybody agrees to, that we are against military intervention from outside, and whatever the Syrians agree to is welcome to us, except perhaps if you have a fundamentalist, extremist group coming on top and governing the country, which I don't think is unacceptable to anybody else.
No one wants that.
Yeah.
Or someone, but maybe Iran. But
no, I don't think so. I don't think Iran wants a fundamentalist Sunni,
Sunni
state.
Yeah, right. So explain to us, because you're there and you're on the ground talking to people, what is it they fear? And are those fears legitimate, that people do not know who would come to power if Assad leaves power?
You know, we go back again to the surprising aspect of the Arab Spring. Nobody has predicted anything that has happened in the Arab world since almost 2 years now, I mean, since that Tunisian young man put himself to fire. So here again, I think there is an element of unknown. You know, you have for example, this opposition, this armed opposition, which is making a lot of progress in Syria. Who are they? Who are the groups that are actually doing the fighting? You know that there are a lot of defecting soldiers, but you have also a lot of civilians. And you have also groups who call themselves fundamentalists and who are not party of this important development that has taken place in Doha with the unity of the of the opposition.
These are people who are coming in trying to take advantage of the situation, hoping they'll have leverage.
They are it's not only foreigners. You have also a lot of Syrians who are. So I think that I believe what the Russians are saying is that who are these people, and who amongst them is going to take over Syria?
Well, aren't the Americans and everyone else asking that question?
I'm sure they
are. Who is going to take over?
I'm sure they are. But probably they know a little bit more about the other opposition and are hoping that this other opposition, the moderate opposition, the secular opposition, will have a say and will perhaps have the upper hand. Whereas the Russians have, they also are having contacts with the opposition. They say that they are open to have talks with everybody, but perhaps they have less contacts with the opposition than the Western countries.